You're listening to Southeast Radio's Business Matters with Karl Fitzpatrick in association with Wexford Insurances. Challenge us at Wexford Insurances, 0818 31 30 30.
My first guest this morning is Deirdre Delaney from Delaney Concrete, who picked up the Green Business of the Year Award at the Wexford Business Awards. Deirdre, start by telling me a bit about your own background, please.
I joined Delaney Concrete in 2005. I had just completed a degree in environmental management. My role has evolved over the years, and now I will be involved more in the marketing side of the business as well.
I know that Delaney Concrete was established back in 1979 by your father, Morris. Tell me about how that came about in the first place.
Morris had been working in London for a good few years, and when he came home he realised that there was an opening in the market for precast concrete elements for buildings like windowsills and lintels, and then he also manufactured curbs and fencing and those smaller products at that stage.
Has the business evolved much over the last 30 years?
It's evolved a lot. We're on our third factory now. We have a very wide range of products to suit all sorts of businesses and enterprises at the moment. We were originally in Ballinabula. That would have been when we were making our smaller products. Then we moved to Sparrowsland in Bree, where most people will remember us from. And at that stage, we launched the BioCrete wastewater treatment system. So that really set us down the road of wastewater and environmental protection. And that is still one of the core elements of our business. In 2007, we moved to our current premises in Clonroach, and that has given us a lot more scope with our quality control and our product range as well. So we've got two recessions and three factories under our belt now at this stage.
Tell me, what prompted you to diversify the business into the wastewater treatment area? You were a manufacturing company by nature, and you then took a shift into the wastewater treatment area. What prompted that?
Morris would be a very forward-thinking person, and back in the mid-1980s when he started doing precast concrete septic tanks, there would have been a move away from the old blockwork septic tanks towards precast concrete. Then in 1999, as more stringent regulations for wastewater started to come down the line, both from the EPA and the local authorities, he decided to manufacture the BioCrete wastewater treatment system. And then as time has moved on, we've also introduced the BioBarrier wastewater treatment system and some other wastewater devices into our range.
Tell me a bit about the BioCrete system first.
The BioCrete system is a wastewater treatment system that takes all the wastewater from your house, uses the bacteria that's naturally present in that waste to break it down through aeration and settlement, and then the treated effluent then goes from there to your percolation area where it soaks down into the groundwater then. So it's a very efficient way of treating regular household wastewater.
You also mentioned the BioBarrier system. How does that work?
The BioBarrier system uses membranes, which is a new technology for the household level, even though it has been used in industrial level for a while. The membranes stop bacteria from leaving the tank, so you've got much more bacteria in the tank to digest the waste, and you get a very clean effluent. The liquid from the BioBarrier wastewater treatment system is actually certified for reuse in America, so you could bring that water back into your house and use it for flushing toilets if you needed to. And we don't have water shortages here, but in our own unit that we have set up in the factory, we have a fish pond after it. It's clean enough to support the fish life and the plants that we have in the pond.
Being a concrete company, were you very much dependent on the construction sector over the past 10 years?
The construction sector has always been our main customer, so the current recession has had a huge impact on us. We've had to broaden our product range, and we've had to look at other sectors of the economy for some support. So we've introduced the Delcast drinking troughs at that stage. We've also only this week introduced a unit for oil tank protection to protect people's home heating oils and diesel oil tanks from the thefts that are happening at the moment. So we have had to open our eyes and look broader than the construction industry, but it's still our main customer. We were impacted a little bit later than a lot of construction companies by the recession, because our main customer would have been the self-builder or the builder who was building single houses out in the country, and the recession didn't start for us until a lot later than it started for other businesses, so we were able to prepare then for the recession more so than other people had the chance to do.
Opinion out there is that the agricultural sector is going very, very well. Are you finding that in your own business?
To a certain extent, we are. The products that we supply at the moment to the agricultural sector will be tanks for rainwater harvesting, and then drinking troughs as well. And we had two good years with drinking troughs after that big bad snow that we had during the winters. But our main drinking troughs go down to the dairy areas in Cork and Kerry, where dairy is a big industry and getting water to cows is very important. And we've also begun to look into exporting those as well. So it is a boom sector at the moment, but you obviously have to have the right product for the farmers too. And that's where redesigning the Delcast troughs to give farmers exactly what they want was an important part of for us to cope with the recession during the winter time.
It certainly sounds like new product development is key to the ongoing success of the business itself. Have you an internal market research team that keep an eye on positive trends and changing trends within the economy in that respect?
That team tends to be myself and Morris, but our customers do a lot of that for us. We're lucky enough to have customers who can approach us and talk to us about their needs.
How automated is the process in your manufacturing facility today?
It's very automated, and we have automated batching. We know exactly what goes into every mix, and we also use self-compacting concrete as well, so we have no vibration to happen as in the wet concrete. Some of our moulds are manually emptied, some of them are on a multicaster, and we also have our own quality control lab as well, which also helps with the automation. We know what works and what doesn't. So we will be very automated, but at the same time, we still have a core staff that are very important to the company. Our staff are also important, not just the automation.
I see also that you've recently introduced rainwater harvesting systems. Tell me a bit about those.
Rainwater harvesting systems was something that happened quite naturally to our business. We were supplying rainwater harvesting units without any branding on them during the boom because there was a certain amount of demand there for them. But we decided to brand it as the Rain Reaper system. And now we have all the filters and equipment to go into the rainwater harvesting tanks for householders, schools, community centres and agriculture. And a lot of people are already paying water charges for their businesses or their community ventures, and a lot of the water charges is going to toilet flushing, and there's no need to use fresh mains water for toilet flushing when you can collect your own rainwater and reuse it for that kind of thing.
So have you seen much of a demand from homeowners at this stage, or do you think that will step in once water rates are being charged to the domestic economy?
Well, water charges is what's really going to kick off rainwater harvesting. At the moment, a lot of people who are doing new builds are putting in dual plumbing systems, and then they'll fit the tank then when maybe they have a little bit saved up after the build is over and they know that water charges are coming in, they'll fit the tank and the tank equipment at that stage. So it's definitely something that people are planning for in the future, even if they're not implementing it straight away.
I know one of the core activities you're involved in with your own business is wastewater treatment, and the change in septic tank regulations that's coming in, bringing about the inspection of septic tanks as a mandatory requirement on domestic dwellings across the country. What effect is that going to have on your business in the future?
We're hoping that'll have a very big positive effect on our business. We have always done a certain amount of upgrades of septic tanks over the years, during the summertime mainly, because that's living with a failed septic tank is not a nice way to have your garden. So a certain amount of septic tanks would be upgraded every year. But with the new inspections, people who maybe have ignored problems or didn't even know they had a problem, it'll be brought to their attention and they will have to do something about it.
As I said at the start of the interview, you scooped the Green Business Award at the Wexford Business Awards last week. So congratulations in respect of that. What does it mean for the business?
Thanks very much, Carl. It means an awful lot to us. We've been in the wastewater treatment sector now since 1999. But we also look into how we can protect the environment through our manufacturing process. When we introduced self-compacting concrete, that cut down vibration, so it made our working environment much better. We're also very conscious of our waste and how we eliminate waste, really, rather than reduce or recycle. So it means a lot to us, and we hope to continue to stand by our core values of wastewater treatment and environmental improvement that way. It also gives us confidence to move forward with our newer products like the BioBarrier. We know that it's a great system, and it shines the light on how these systems are going to be fitting into our national wastewater strategy in the future. It also has given us the confidence that maybe if there is another awards competition, in even on a national level, that we will consider entering it. It's also given us a lot of positive PR. I wouldn't be here doing this interview with you today, Karl, if it wasn't for this award. So it really means a lot, and all our staff are very proud of it.
What does the future hold for Delaney Concrete?
Hopefully we'll have a long future with lots of interesting products for our customers. We're going to continue to improve wastewater treatment, both in County Wexford and all over Ireland. We're also going to continue to provide a high quality product for our builders, for our building customers, be they self-build or builders. And we will continue to look for products for the agricultural industry and even unusual products that maybe people wouldn't think of, like our oil tanks or whatever the future will bring, Karl. We'll keep our minds open and look for those products and bring them to our customers.
Well, Deirdre, thank you for dropping by this morning, and I wish you continued success.
You're listening to Southeast Radio's Business Matters with Karl Fitzpatrick in association with Wexford Insurances. Think Wexford Insurances for your business insurance.